following show is brought to you in living color by El Segundo Tuna, where the sewer meets the sea. El Segundo Tuna is for you and me. Really, it is.
All right, here we go. One, two, three.
It's the Jeff Gilbert Show, featuring Jeff Gilbert with Sue Albano, Peter Babcock, Dana Land, Roger Roten, Tobias the Mystic, music by the John Simon Trio, and special guest Stan Pappas.
We make each other laugh, we make each other sing, and you can never ever overdo a good thing, so why don't we do this more often?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Jeff Gilbert Show. My name is Jeff Gilbert, and I'll be your host for the next 60 minutes, where we have some of the great talent from the town of Sonoma, the toast of the town. Join us on our parade of song and mirth, with a few surprises along the way, but we open things up with the lovely Dana Land, right here.
Was written by Henry Mancini for the film Pink Panther, and the original Pink Panther in 1964. And it's a song that speaks of a woman who wants it and wants it now. Va subito is Italian for immediately. If you're ever gonna kiss me, be a nice Italiano and start
Sensual and very soothing. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we bring to you now the cleanest act in show business, a man who has toured all over the world and even America, Mr. Peter Babcock.
Radio, remember radio. We'd sit and close our eyes and use our imagination. Comedy, mystery, a fireside chat. Together we sat listening nightly to our favorite shows. Oh, radio, why did you ever go? Oh, won't you please come back and entertain us? I long to turn the dial again and hear the past and smile again. Radio, I miss you so. All right, anybody out there remember radio? Raise your hands. You're way too young. What was your favorite show? Very good, very good. Anybody else? Radio, right here in the front.
The morning show.
The morning? The morning show on KSVY. Excellent. Nice choice, Ken. You owe me. You definitely owe me. Anyway, radio is such a medium, and we have one of the best voices right here in KSVY. So we're going to take you back a little further now. See if you remember these shows. Major Bowes, I miss the Shadow Nose, Fred Allen's Alley Cats, the laughter from Duffy's Tavern, Helen Trent. Then we went to Can You Top This? Suspense and the Whistler would send those shivers up our spine. Oh, Uncle Don, I wish you still were on. Jack Armstrong, Merton Marge, Amos and Andy. I long to turn the dial again and hear the past and smile again. Radio, I miss you so. Whoa, 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 whoa. Radio, I miss you so. Oh, oh, oh. Thank you.
Thank you, Peter Babcock. Ladies and gentlemen, we now bring to you a lovely songstress by the name of Sue Albano, and she's going to take us on a little bit of a sentimental journey.
Hello, everybody. Come and take a sentimental journey.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now bring to you a prestidigitator with a plus, the magic man himself, Mr. Roger Roten. Thank you. Thank you, Roger Roten, the magic man. Ladies and gentlemen, a rare treat's in store now. We bring to you Stan Pappas and the debut of the Stanlets.
That's life, that's what all the people say. Flying high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June. I said that's life. I can't deny it. Many times I thought of cutting out, but my heart won't buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up, down, over and out. And I know one thing, each time I find myself flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life, that's life, and I can't deny it. Many times I thought of cutting out, but my heart won't buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die. 'Cause I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up, down, over and out. And I know one thing, each time I find myself flat on my face, I just pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life, that's life, and I can't deny it. Many times I thought of cutting out, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die.
Stan Pappas and the Stanlets, a.k.a. the Bearded Ladies. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we bring to you the mystic, Tobias. Thank you.
yet.
Thank you, Tobias the Mystic. And now, ladies and gentlemen, once again, the lovely Dana Land.
So this, too, it was written by Harold Arlen and E.Y. Harbour for the 1939 film The Wizard of Oz. And I would like to dedicate this to anybody out there who, if at any time you wished you had a little bit more in the brain department, or the heart department, or the courage department. This goes out to all of you. Said a scarecrow, swinging on a pole, to a blackbird sitting on a fence. Gave me a soul, but forgot to give me common sense. If I had an ounce of common sense, I could while away the hours conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel any riddle for any individual in trouble or pain. Why with my thoughts I'd be thinking I could be another Lincoln if I only had a brain. Oh, 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 I could tell you why the ocean is near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before. And then I'd sit and think some more. My head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. And perhaps I deserve you and be even worthy of you if I only had a brain. I see devotion and really feel the part. Well, I would stay young and sugar, and I'd lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart. Yeah, said a lion, porn neurotic lion, to a miss who listened to him rave. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but forgot to make me brave. Then his tail began to curl and wave. Life is sad, believe me, missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the feminine voice.
Thank you, Dana Land, beautiful as always. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a very rare treat, Confessions of a Shoe Salesman.
Remember 35 years ago, we were doing these snakeskin shoes?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm at Vegas. This woman comes in, Mrs. Schwartz, big buyer for a department store. She comes in, she goes, Mr. Pappas, show me what you got. I showed her all these snakes, start showing her the snakeskin shoes. She goes, do you have anything else? You have leather, patent leather, fabric? I said, we're pushing snakeskin because we really believe in snakeskin. She goes, I'm not buying snakeskin. Well, how can you just say that? I haven't even showed you this. I'm not buying snakeskin because they're uncomfortable. They're stiff. I bought them 7 years ago. They sucked. I don't want them. I said, Mrs. Schwartz, I can understand 7 years ago. They were stiff. You're right. But there was a reason for that. 7 years ago, when we did shoes and snakeskin, we put all the snakes in this big box, and we got a gun, and you shot them. Well, they died. But they die like that. When you get shot like that, you go like that, you stiffen up. Well, we don't do that anymore, Mrs. Schwartz. What we do now is we pick up the snake and we gently hand strangle the snake. And when you get strangled, you get limp when you die. So on the shoe boxes, it's going to say, genuine hand strangled. And that's why our snake skins are soft, they're comfortable, they're gonna sell, you need to buy them. She bought them. What I didn't tell her was that they were really salmon fish scales.
That's a fishy story.
Ah, that was very revealing and informative. I did not know that. Ah, now here is the lovely Sue Albano and me.
Never thought that you would be standing here so close to me. There's so much I feel that I could say, but words can wait until some other day. Kiss me once and kiss me twice and kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time. Haven't felt like this, my dear, since can't remember when. It's been a long, long time. You'll never know. Kiss me once and kiss me twice and kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time.
Thank you, Sue. Boy. And now here he is, once again, Peter Babcock.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to be back, as they say in show business. Right now, I'd like to explain this thing that I have around my neck. It's, the vernacular is a gynostifer, J-Y-N-O-S-T-I-F-E-R. And I am a gynostiferic. But this is really basically known as a national 28 washboard made in Memphis, Tennessee. And I put the whole thing together. We start off with the national 28 washboard. Sounds something like this. Ooh, round of applause, thank you. Then we go to the Quinlan pretzel tin. This is the Quinlan pretzel tin that used to hold Quinlan pretzels way back in 1898, before cellophane and plastic. It is my base effect. And from there we go to two ashtrays bolted together, giving me my treble effect. And from there, ladies and gentlemen, we go to an empty Edsel body cleaner can that used to hold the contents that used to clean Edsel bodies way back in 1958. It is my tenor effect. From there, we go to the Acme siren. This is a siren made in England, and it was used in the coronation of Queen Elizabeth way back in 1953. And the first words she heard as she stepped off the coronation coach were, "Would you like to be queen for a day?" You remember the show? Good, good, good. Anyway, I'd like to continue doing the silly song that I was starting out to do. It's in Coney. It's entitled Coney Island Washboard. It was written in 1926 and performed by the Harmaniacs. And they recorded it. I think they recorded it. I think it was a 78, as I recall. I wasn't there at the recording, but I think it's a 78. Anyway, it's entitled Coney Island, a Washboard. Maestro, please. Coney Island Washboard, she would play. She would play it on the boardwalk every day. Soapsuds on the ground. Bubbles all around. Rub-a-dub-a-dub. Rub-a-dub-a-dub. All the tunes she found. Thimbles on her fingers made the noise. She would do it on the boardwalk for the boys. Well, she could rag a tune right to through a brand new pair of BVDs. They used to make those. Coney Island Washboard Rondo Lake 2-3-4. On the ground, bubbles all around, rub it up, all the tunes she found. Well, thimbles on his fingers made the noise. Threw it on the boardwalk for the boys. She could rag a tune right through a brand new pair of BVDs. Coney Island Washboard Rondo, la 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 la. Coney Island Washboard Rondo, la.
Thank you, Peter E. Babcock, man. That guy is Down Home Entertainment. A big thumbs up. Now, our next guest is someone that's very dear to my heart. I almost love him as much as I love my Hillary. Now, as you know, he's not only dashing and debonair, but he's got a lot of nice radios. I forget his name, but you may remember him from something. He is familiar right here. Where's my cigar?
I'd like to take you back now on a journey celebrating the great entertainers that once were on radio back in the 1930s, whose careers were launched by radio. Because in certain areas of the country, in rural areas, people never saw a show or a film, but of course the magic medium of radio, they were transported to other places and great singers came over the air. And with that, we open up the stage here and show you my radio collection. Well, we take you back to, that's 1923, the radio in the middle, and in that year, that is the very first commercially sold radio to, it was $180 in 1923, that's quite a lot. But through that horn, many a great singer came through, and four singers, four boys and a guitar, Harry Herb and Donald Mills, and John Jr. made up the Mills Brothers, and they did all their songs without really a band, maybe a bass, and like kind of like this, and the rest of the instruments were all done by them. But without further ado, we bring you back to 1923, Harry Herb and Donald Mills with Dinah. One, two, three, four. Oh, Dinah, is there anyone finer in the state of Carolina? I'm sorry, I'm in the wrong key. Oh, dee da do da da dee dee, Dinah. Should you wander to China, I would hop an ocean liner just to be with Dinah Lynn. Oh, Dinah, every night, why do I just shake with fright? Because my little dynamite might change her mind about me. Boom, boom, whip, boom, 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 Dinah. Should you wander over to China, I'd hop an ocean liner just to be with Dinah Lee one more time. Da 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 Why do I just shake with fright? You know, because my dynamite might change her mind about me. Boom, boom, whip-a-boop-boop, Dinah. Should you want to China, I would hop an ocean liner just to be with Dinah Lee. Well, a few years later, the great medium of radio brought us the Vagabond Lover, a man who brought variety to radio. He not only brought Broadway shows, readings on the radio with the great stars, introduced many a great singer, Alice Faye, Dorothy L'Amour, and he also introduced to radio audiences Mr. Ed Sullivan. And without further ado, the Fleischmann's Yeast Hour presents the Vagabond Lover, Rudy Valli. One, two, This is a megaphone that was given to me by Mrs. Rudy Valli back in 1986, and she was glad to get rid of it. But anyway, if you want to touch it after the show, it's 25 cents for the viewing, and if you want to touch it, it's 50 cents. But before we go, at the end of the big band era, Sammy Kay was one of the last great bands to still be broadcasting with the Sunday Serenade, and his vocalist was the great Don Cornell, who had a pretty big solo career back in the 1950s and 60s and was still performing up until his death in the 1990s. But here's a tune that he sang with Sammy Kay. And so here it is, a little tune called It Isn't Fair. This was Don Cornell in 1950, and when he sang it, there wasn't a dry seat in the house. I've been using that for years. I can't get rid of it. It's kind of like this suit. All right, let's see. It's slow. One, two, one, two, three, four. It isn't fair for you to taunt me. Me care this way. It isn't fair for you to want me if it's just for a day. It isn't fair for you to thrill me. Why do you do the things you do? It isn't fair for you to fill me with those dreams that can't come true, dear. Why is it you came into my life and made it so complete? You gave me just a taste of high life. If this is love, then I repeat. It isn't fair for you to taunt me. How can you make me care this way? It isn't fair for you to want me if it's just for today.